Welcome to session 2, learning relating to future value of annuity regular. In session 1, we learnt relating to the fundamentals and example on topic future value. Today in session 2, we'll continue with the formula learning relating to annuity regular only. And also we will solve 3 different types of questions relating to annuity regular. So let's start this session 2, and also in session 3 I am going to discuss 7 more questions relating to annuity regular. Let's start this session. You already know the meaning of annuity regular. Another word of annuity regular is annuity ordinary, right? So annuity ordinary is also called as annuity regular, and in case of annuity regular, here the annuity is calculated at the end of the term. At the end of the term, the annuity gets applicable. Now we'll see the formula relating to annuity regular. The formula is A into big bracket open 1 plus I to the power n minus 1 whole divided by I big bracket close. Let me repeat. A into big bracket open 1 plus I to the power n minus 1 divided by I. So here A stands for annuity what is paid or received, and in case of I it is interest rate of interest. N stands for time. So this is the formula relating to computation of future value of annuity regular. Now we'll start solving the different questions under this topic. Let's start solving the question 1 under the topic annuity regular. Find the future value of an annuity of rupees 500 made annually. Okay, so the annuity is 500 made annually for 7 years at interest rate 14% compounded annually, given 1.14 to the power 7 is equal to 2.5023. This is your question. So we are supposed to find out the future value of annuity. How do we find out whether this is annuity regular or other one? So here rupees 500 made annually. Annually means on the completion of that year or annual term. So here it is annuity regular question given. So we have to write the formula first. We can write it like this. Annuity regular or AR is equal to A into big bracket open 1 plus I to the power n minus 1 whole divided by I. So we'll write first what are the components given here. A, that is annuity. Annuity is how much? Rupees 500 given in the question. Next, what we require? I. I is equal to 14%. So 14%, no need of conversions as it is compounded annually. So even if you divide it by 1, it becomes 14% itself is nothing but 0.14. So you divide 14 divided by 100, you get it as 0.14, and n is given as how many years? 7. So even if you multiply it with 1, answer will be 7 itself. So after conversions, n will be 7 itself. So we have this information. So we'll substitute in the formula. So 500 into big bracket open 1 plus 0.14 to the power n is 7 minus 1 divided by I is 0.14 bracket close. Okay, so let me continue here. 500 into big bracket open, this will become 1.14. okay, so 1.14 to the power 7 minus 1 divided by 0.14. so let's make some calculations in the calculator. 1.14 to the power 7, right? So 1.14 to the power 7, you can click on multiply symbol, then equal to 6 times into 1 2 3 4 5 6, and your answer is 2.5022, or you can convert it, make it to the nearest 5, 2.5023 minus 1 divided by 0.14 into 500. All right, so let's do the calculation and find out the final answer. 2.5023 minus 1 is 1.5023 divided by 0.14. You get it as 10.73071. Multiply it with 500 and your answer will be 5365.35 or 36. 5365.36. Let's start solving question 2. Question 2 is like this. Rupees 200 is invested at the end of each month in an account paying interest rate of 6% per year, compounded monthly. It is compounded monthly. What is the future value of annuity after the 10th payment, given 1.005 to the power 10 is equal to 1.0511. So annuity is equal to rupees 200. Next we need n is equal to, it is given each month, so 1 month into number of conversions, how many months at the 10th payment, so 10 is equal to 10 months, n is 10. And I is equal to, it's given as 6%. 6% is nothing but 0.06, okay, divided by number of conversions. So how many times the conversions here is, in one full year there is conversions 12 times. So divide it by 12. So the answer would be 0.06 divided by 12. You get it as 0.005. Alright, we have the necessary information here. Now we'll write down the formula, that is annuity regular is equal to A into 1 plus I to the power N minus 1 divided by I. Okay, so annuity amount is 200 into 1 plus I. What is I here right now? 0.005 to the power n. N is 10 minus 1 whole divided by 0.005. Okay, so let's write further in a simplified manner into big bracket open. Now do this calculation. 1 plus 0.005 becomes 1.005 in the calculator. Find out the 10th power of it. 1.005 into, find the 10th power into, click 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1.0511. Okay, 1.0511 minus 1 divided by 0.005, bracket close. Let me continue it here. Okay, so write it like this. 200 into bracket open, 1.0511 minus 1 becomes 0.0511 divided by 0.005. In your calculators, find out the final answers. We are nearing the final answer. 0.0511 divided by 0.005. It is 10.22. Multiply it with 200 into 200. And your answer will be 2044. Your answer will be 2044. So the future value of annuity relating to 200, which is invested every month, okay, and the 10th payment, the value is, future value is 2044. So we have found the answer for second question. Let's move on to the third question. Let me read out question 3 for you. If a bank pays 6% interest compounded quarterly, what equal deposit must be made at the end of each quarter for 3 years if you want to have rupees 1500 at the end of 3 years? So this 1500 is nothing but future value, and as it is mentioned here, at the end of each quarter. Now future value of annuity regular is already given. So what are we supposed to find here? Just look at the question once again. The question here is, we are supposed to find out the annuity. Annuity we do not know. Okay, so let's start solving this. Annuity we do not know. Future value of annuity regular is given. What is that? Rupees 1500. Then next one is I is equal to, they have given 6% interest rate compounded quarterly. 6% is nothing but 0.06. Number of conversions, quarterly means 4 times. So answer will be 0.015. Okay. So N, next we need is N. N is equal to, they have said for 3 years. So 3 years into number of quarters in a year is 4. That is equal to 12. Fine. So we'll first write the formula. So future value of annuity regular is equal to annuity into big bracket open 1 plus I to the power n minus 1 divided by I bracket close. This is the formula. So now we'll substitute the values whatever we have in the question. So future value of annuity regular is 1500. Annuity we do not know, keep it as A itself, big bracket open, 1 plus I, what is I? 0.015 to the power n, n is 12, minus 1 divided by I is 0.015. okay, so we'll see this. 1500 is equal to A into big bracket open the calculator, and let's solve this. 1 plus 0.015 becomes 1.015, right, into 12 times, to the power 12 times. So click on into, then click equal to 11 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 1.1956. So from that you deduct 1 minus 1. Okay, we got 0.0956. To this answer, divide it by 0.015. Divide by 0.015. So you get it as 13.0412. Alright, so let me continue here. 1500 is equal to A into 13.0412. So A is equal to 1500 divided by 13.0412. Calculate this. 1500 divided by 13.0412. It gives you 115.02. So annuity is equal to 115.02. So we have found the annuity. So this is the answer for question 3. Thanks for watching this session. In the next session 3, I am going to discuss 7 more questions relating to future value of annuity regular computations.